Hi, I'm Rosalie Brown. Welcome to the world of personal trainer fitness. At PT Fitness, we have a whole menu of fitness programs. As a matter of fact, studies show that the more you cross-train or vary your exercise programs, the faster and better results you'll receive. You're going to be working smarter, not harder. PT Fitness offers programs for weight training, such as our 30-pound body shaping program, our body gym, multi-bench, and PT exercise ball, to name a few. In our aerobic section, we offer PT cycle, step, trampoline, and jump rope programs. We also have a full selection of fitness accessories, such as weights, gloves, chinning bars, hand grips, ab wheels, and more. The main focus of our program is to get you results fast. Many of our programs are timed and teach you how to work smarter, not harder. As a fitness professional for over 20 years, teaching well over 6,000 classes, I've worked with children, seniors, professional athletes, and celebrities. I know what works. At PT Fitness, we've designed the program that's going to work for you, whether you're a beginner or whether you're an expert. Here's to your health and fitness. Welcome to PT Training Program. Weight training is imperative for men and women. The more muscle you have in the body, the more calories your body's gonna burn. So women, muscle training keeps you lean. Men, you can bulk up with weight training because you have testosterone. We only have sparse amounts. Now let's get ready with the PT program. Bend the knees, inhale up. Today, Wendy's joining me for the workout. Do that again. We're just gonna do a light warm-up, warming up the bodies, getting ready for weight training. One more time like that. All right, now let's loosen up the shoulders. And left. Loosen up. You got it. Give me four and three. Now two times on one side. Go two. Switch it out. Singles right here. Take it up. Now we're going to take the elbow a little higher. Roll back. Four and three. Now take that arm in front of the body. Big circle. Four and three. Now two times. One side. Go two. Round and round. Switch up. Another set of two. Good. Yes. And back to singles. One each. Take it round and round. Back to an elbow lead. Roll back. Warming up the back. And shoulder roll. Pull through. Out. Now let's add the legs. Pushing off the floor. Push and push and push. You got it. Four and three. Now release the arms. Take it out. Good. Just gently warming up the body in four and three. Take those arms across the chest. Yes. Pull and pull. Nice. Four, three, two. Now two arms pulling back. And open up a little wider. Hit the triceps. Good. Now pull back. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Now tries. Open. One each. Take it in and out. You got it. In and out. Two more. Here's one. Last time. Now reaching right and left. Go. Push. Up. Nice. Few more. Four. Three. Take it across the chest. And push. And push. Two more. Here's one. Now just take the right arm and reach over and out. Two more. Here's one. Other side. Release. Out and over. Two more. Here's one. Now two arms. Press forward. Go. And take it down. Push down. Back to the chest. Take it up. Chest. And down. Again for chest. Yes. Reach high. Back to chest and hold it down. Stay here for four and three. Side step, gentle step, push. Now pull the arms as you step. Good. Now press the arms down, push down for four and three. Now pull it in for four. Yes. Now press down for two. Pull back. Do that again, push down. Good. Pull back. Now singles. Push and pull. Push and pull. Looking good. And four and three. Hold the pull. Now flex your legs. Flex. Waking up those hamstrings. Yes. Pull and pull. Four more like this. Four and three. Now sidestep four times. four, and three. Flex back four times. Four, three. Side step two times. Flex it back. Side step, good. Flex back. Now stay here with the flex. Four more, last four, and three. Two, wide leg, lean out. Body tall, abs in. Gently stretch out through that inner thigh. Take it lower, yeah. Four, and three, last two. One more time, and hold it. For four, and three, and two. Other side, gentle stretch for four, and three. Back to singles, one each. Push, push, now into the center. Pulsing down for eight, seven, six. Just gentle, four, three. Now round your back up and roll up. All the way up, down again. Nice, round up. One more time, all the way up. And inhale, good. And exhale, one more time. Good work. All right, let's start the weight training. Should be nice and toasty. Start with your wide bar. We're gonna start off with squats, working the legs. So take your bar behind your head, wide grip, legs at least shoulder width apart. Now when you do a squat, make sure your buttock drives back, your knees stay behind the toe. Here we go, two counts down, and up. Again, down, hold, up, up. Nice, down, hold, up, up. Now this time, halfway lift, halfway. Up, down, seven, and six, and five. Good, four, and three, and two. Now let's take it all the way up for two counts. Take it up, one, two, and down, two. Again, up, two, and down, two more. Here's one, one more time like that. Now here comes that half squat again. Here we go, take it half for eight, and down, seven, good, six, and five. Four more, stay with me. Toes are light, put the weight into your heels. Three, give me two. Let's take it up for two counts all the way up. Push and down. Again, here's three more. And down, two more, here's two. One more, one more. Here comes that half squat, finish it with me. Eight, seven, six, yes. Five, four, three, two, and all the way up, go all the way up. And all the way down, nice. One more like that. Stay up, now we're gonna go into a lunge. So turn your body, back leg's gonna lead, and let's take it down for two counts. Here we go, down, and up, yes. Down, three more, take it down, good. Two more, one more, keep that body tall. All right, one more. And let's do that half lift. Here we go. Up and seven, lean back. Six, five, four, three, two. Pivot to the center, take it down for two, squat. Now remember, if you wanna make this more challenging, all you need to do is add more weight. Less challenging, less weight. One more like this and pivot turn, lunging. Back leg down for two. Down and up, you got it. And up, three more, down, and up, two more, good. Here we go, I need one more after this, here we go, give me one more, and half, eight, seven, good, six, five, four, three, two, take it center. Toes wide this time, let's get inner and outer thighs. Back tall, take it down, and take it up. Do that again. Down, two, up, two. Make sure the knees stay behind your toe. Yes, do that again. Down, two, one more like that. Here comes the half squat, take it half. Eight, seven, six, good. Five, four, three, here we go, all the way up for two counts. Push and down again for two. And push up and down. Two more. Up. One more like that, and here comes that half squat. Here it comes. Give me 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Come all the way up and down. One more time. Come all the way up. All right, let's give those legs a bit of work. We're going to work our lats, our back. So take your bar in front, wide legs, bend your knees, and you're going to pull with your elbows leading above your back. Here we go. Take it up and down. Yes. Hold. Lift. Squeeze your shoulder blades every time. Ah, you got it. Thinking about the back. Few more, few more. 8, 7, good. 6, 5, 4 more. Here we come. 4, abs in. 3, 2 more. 2, and take it to the floor. All right, what we're gonna do now is just change our grip. Palms go under, pulling in towards the abdominals. Here we go. And pull, release, pull. Make sure you hold on top. Squeeze, release. Yes, 8 more. 8, 7, good. 6, 5, 4 more like that. 4, and 3. Last 2, 1 more. All right, back to that wide position. Hands on top. All right, this is our last set. 12, 11, nice. 10, 9. Make sure those elbows come up nice and high. Don't rush the move. Pull. Good. 3 more. 2 more. Last one. All right, now we're going to work your hamstrings. I want you to stay in this position, but bring your feet a little closer together. One of the few exercises that actually you keep your legs long and tight. Suck in your abdominals, ragdoll your arms. This one, nice loose arm, and you're going to lift your weights using your buttocks. Here we go, into a hang position and lift. Up and down. Now this is working the hamstrings and buttock. A really, really great exercise. But it takes a lot of visualization on this one. You really have to think about squeezing your butt cheeks together, tucking it under. Hold, big contraction. Make sure you don't rush the move. Pull and squeeze. Good. Keep staying with me. Give me 8 more. And 7. Nice. 6, 5 more. Looking good. 4, and 3. Last 2, and 1 more. Bend your knees as you take it down. All right, grab your bar wide. We're gonna do some shoulder presses and add a squat to that. So let's just start with the shoulder presses first of all. Here we go. 8, and 7, 6, good. 5, keep those arms wide. 4, 3, 2. Now on this one, I want you to take it behind the head and squat down, and push up, push, now squat, nice, again, press, hold, squat, down, push, hold, squat, check those knees on those squats, make sure they stay behind the toes, push, and down, and up. If you can work out with a mirror, it's great, because you can really check up on that technique. But the squat, one of the exercises that a lot of people tend to make the mistake on, what you can do is try and visualize that from your knees down to your ankles, you're stuck in cement. And the only way you move is by leaning back with your buttock. So try to visualize that. Nice. Here we go, one more. Now we're just gonna hold the squat for 8 and 7. Soft knee on the way up. 6, never lock out. 5, looking good. 4, 3 more. Last 2, and 1. Excellent. Now we're gonna work with the separate hand weights. So put your bar down, grab your separate hand weights, and again, you decide how much you need. Remember that the bar weighs 1 pound. So whatever you add, for instance, I have the 2, and my bar equals the 5 pound weight. Here we go, let's start with upright rows. Lift, and lower. Good. Remember to squeeze at the top. 8 and 7. Nice. 6, 5. 4 more. Up. Good. 2 more. Last one. Now we're going to do a side lift, which works shoulders and lats. Take it out to the side and down. Now when you do this exercise, I want you to make sure that you just lift to shoulder height. No higher. Take it up and notice how my elbows are slightly behind my back. Lift and hold and down. Do that again. Up and hold. Nice. Few more. Lift, hold. So the only difference between a beginner and advanced person would be the size of the weights that you're using. Because a bicep curl is a bicep curl, whether this is your first day or whether you've been doing this for years. It's all about weight and intensity. So no matter where you are in your fitness program, this can suit your needs. Here we go. Lift and hold. Technique comes first, guys. If you're wavering on your technique, it means you need a lighter weight. Don't compromise technique with too much weight. Again, up. All right, I think we got one more. Here we go. Up and single rows to release. Just 4 of them. 4 and 3. 2 more. 2. Now we're going to take a straight arm lift in front. Thumbs up. Up and hold. And down. Again, don't lift higher than the shoulder. Lift and hold. This is excellent for working the shoulders and chest. If you need a little more challenge, you can put the palms down. Lift and hold. So since Wendy's doing the hard work today, she can stay with the thumbs up. And I'll put my palms down for a little more challenge. Up, hold. Do that again. Good, up. Or you can combine. Find you're getting a little fatigued, just rotate with the thumb up. Nice, 4 more. We got 4 and down. Notice the control. The less swing, the more effective the move. Last 2. Here we go. 1. 1 more, keeping that body tall. Up. Here we go into upright rows to release. That feels good, doesn't it? 4 more of these. And 3 and 2. Now we're going to work the upper chest. Palms up. So it comes up above the chest and down. Now you can modify this exercise by going back to that thumb lift, because this is a challenging exercise. Or again, you can lighten your weights, and you can also use the weights without the bar. So if you're just starting, you may want to just use the weights without the bar. Good. Up, hold, down, down. Up, hold. Just 2 more, Wen.
Okay.
1, ho. Good. 1 more, yeah. All right, let's release with those rows. Take it. Up and down, nice. 2 more of these. Now we're gonna go into a bicep curl with a shoulder press. Here it goes. In, push, down, down. Now notice Wendy and my stance. No pelvic tilt in this classroom. Our bodies are tall, our abdominals are tucked in, and we try not to swing the weights. Everything's pressed and control. Lift, push, nice. Do that again, up. Press. Let's do 2 more of those. Here's 1. Good. Last one. I want you to stay up on this one and pull wide, working just the shoulders. Out. Drive up. Wide and push. Stop the elbow at shoulder height. Hold. Then drive up. Hold. Drive up. Good. 8 more. Here they go. 8. Push. 7. Nice. 6 and 5, 4 more, 4, last 3, give me 2, now I want you to hold the weights on top and go into triceps for 2 counts, 1, 2, push, 2, so drop it back and push it up, drop it back, now let's go into singles, take it down, up, now if this is too challenging, please, feel free to put one of your weights down. Down, push. So this workout can grow with you. All you need to do is add more weight. Press. The most important part in the tricep is right here, the push up. Release, drive it up. Extend those arms fully. Give me 4 more. Nice. 3 more. 2 more. Now hold it wide back to shoulders. Here we go. Out and up. Nice. Push. Out. Push. Now if you take the weight slightly in front, you can work a little more of your chest. Take them slightly behind. You can engage more back. So vary your workouts. Challenge different muscle groups. Out and up. Out. Nice. A little more chest. Bring it in front. Good. Two more. And let's take some behind. For four. And three. Last two, stay up. Let's do one more set of triceps. Drop back. Push up. Nice. Eight more. Eight. Push. Elbows high. Body tall. Hold. Squeeze on top. Four more. Three more. Two more, and let's roll it down. Yes. Those triceps are done. All right, we're gonna work the shoulders. Bringing the elbows in front, and you're gonna lead with your shoulders. So it looks like this. Lift and lower. Now squeeze in together. Lift and squeeze that in. Do that again. Take it up and down. Nice, body tall. It's always easier on your body to have a nice wide stance. Now throughout this routine, I really want you to make sure that your posture is right on. Your chin and your belly button should stay on the same line throughout the whole workout. Your shoulders down and square. Make sure that head stays in alignment. Chin and belly button, same line. Up, two, down, two, again, yes. Now elbows stay in front on this one. The first exercise we did worked more the lats and shoulders, keeping the elbows in front on this one. Just give me four more. Four. Yeah. Again, lift, hold. Three. Just two more. Here's two. Squeeze in one more. Go, go, go. Nice. All right, biceps. Take it. Up and down. Good. Now with this exercise, you can stay here with your single dumbbells or, and when you stay there, I'll add my bar and I can do my biceps with the bar. So curl and curl. So again, depending how much challenge you need, you really want to work those biceps today. Pick up some heavier weight. Yes. But again, technique before weight. All right. Eight. Seven. Six, five, four more. Make sure you're not rocking that upper body. Stay tall for me. Two more, and one more. Okay, the next move we're gonna do is hit the triceps. So we're gonna do two positions with the triceps. Start with the weight on your buttock, body tall, straddle the leg, and push away, out and in. Now make sure you hold onto that contraction. Hold, squeeze. Yes, again. Two more like that. Now keep the same hand position and bend. Eight, now try to keep your shoulder to your elbow parallel. Push, good. Four more here. Four, hang on to that extension. Three, last two. Back to upright and turn your palm to the back. This is our last set. Seven, six. Good. Five, four more. Give me four and three. Two more, two more. All right, to the center, biceps to release. Woo! Four, good work. Three, two more like this. Tricep, other side. Here we go. Wide leg, place the weight up onto the hip. Elbow stays in that same spot. Now push away. Out, in, hold. Good, press. Remember, the less momentum in your weight work, the more effective your weight work. Don't rush through the movements. Good. Out, in. Just two more in this position. Bring the legs together and push. So the goal is try to get the elbow parallel to the shoulder. Good. Nice. Push, pull, out. If you want to make it more challenging, work on that technique. Two more, one. All right, upright position, palm faces back. So notice how my palm faces the ceiling. Eight. Last seven, this is it, go. Six, and five, four more. Give me four, yes. Three more, two, and one. Woo! Let's do some bicep curls to release out. Yeah. Four of these, three of these, two, and one. Okay, we're gonna take it down onto the floor and we're gonna do a little bit more work on our hamstring area. Keeping your weight, take it onto the floor, place that weight behind your knee, get down on your elbows. Now I need you to hug in that weight. Let's take it up and down, up, good. Push, release, squeeze. Suck in the abdominals, relax in through your upper body, put all the energy into your buttock. Keep going, keep going. Now your buttock, no big surprise, your largest muscle group of the body. So that means that it can take heavier weights. So if you find by your first few repetitions that this is too easy, you may want to steal a heavier weight. And I'm gonna do that, Wendy. I'm taking your other weight. So I'm gonna continue on up because our goal is to make the most use out of our exercise time. So feel free to load up one bar with a little more weight so you can use it to work your hamstrings. Yes, in. Let's just do eight more, here we go. Eight, and seven, six, five, four more, four, good. Three, two, and one. Let's give that a little stretch out. Take the weight off and stretch back. Days like this, I wish I only had one leg. Okay, in between to rest our hamstrings, we're just gonna do a few push-ups. So you can choose knees or feet. And here we go. Take it down, up, good. Let's do 20 more.
Okay.
And 19, 18. And again, feel free to rest and start again. Lead with the chest or feel free to take it down onto your knee in this position. Or if you're just starting, you can even bring your knees right up and bend from here. Are you counting, Wendy? How many left?
I think we're done.
All righty, stretch it back. So always feel free to modify your push-ups and work to that point of fatigue. All right, we've got the other leg to do, hamstrings. Slide that weight behind the knee. Now hug it in, hug that weight in so you don't lose it. Relax your upper body, push and pull. Now remember about momentum, the less, the better. Hold and pull. Plus also visualize the muscle group we're working. We're working in the buttock. Squeeze, release, don't rush the move. Up and in, push, and pull, nice. Few more, come on, stay with me. But then again, if you get tired, it's okay to stop. It's okay, it's okay. You can start up again, except for you, Wendy. You have to stay with me. But yeah, it's all right to stop, rest, and start again. Because the key to changing your body is hitting that point of fatigue. When the muscle fatigues, it means you put stress in through the buttock area. Right now, you're stressing out the buttock. That means when you finished your workout, your muscle has to repair itself. Well, guess what? The process of muscle repair uses stored body fat. So when you fatigue your muscles, you're gonna be burning off body fat. All right, let's do eight more. And seven, you got it. Six, five, four, last three, two, and one. All right, take that weight off and let's stretch back, leaning into that hip area. Good, give me four and three, press, two. All right, one more set of push-up, guys. Just 20, just to make sure we fatigue that chest area. Knees or feet, your choice. Here we go. Take it down and up. Hold. Good, I know you guys like to rush this, and I mean guys by men. Make sure you slow down and press. Slow down and press. Good. We've got about 12 more left. Here they come. 12, push away. 11, nice. 10, suck in the abs. Eight more, 8. Lead with your chest rather than your chin. 6. 5. Go. 4. 3. Last 2. And 1. Oh yes, stretch that one back. Now to stretch this, press your chest into the floor. Reach those arms long like you're lengthening your back. So push down with your chest and reach the arms. In 4 and 3, 2. All right, nothing left but abdominals. And then we're gonna cool it down. So let's work the abdominals. Rolling back. Now let's start with full ranges. Lift and lower. Hold. Notice how we hold every time we lift. Squeeze and lower. Squeeze. 4, 3, 2. Now this time I want you to lift for a 2 beat count. So here it comes. 1, 2, down, 2. Lift, hold, roll back. Lift, hold, roll back. Again, lift, hold. 2 more like that. Lift, hold. 1 more like that. Lift, hold, back to singles. Go. 8 and 7. Press your back into the floor. Notice how my back stays in contact with the floor. 4 more like that. 4, nice. 3 more. 2, now I want you to hold the head up and tap your heels. Now tap tight to your buttock. And if you need more challenge, you can tap further away. Keep your back pressed into the floor as you're tapping. Now I know this is a real advanced move, but it's a really great one to especially target down into the lower part of the abs. Press your back for 4, 3, both feet down, upper body. Lift and lower, lift and lower. Good. One more time, stay up and tap. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, no legs, and lift. And lift. All right, now next time you have a choice here. You can either tap your legs, or you can lift your upper body, or for you fitness fanatics out there, you can combine both. Here we go, lift and tap. Go. And push. Nice. Press. Looking good. Don't rush the upper body. 8 and 7, 6, 5. 4 more. 3. Last 2. Head stays up and just tap for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Feet down. Basic crunch. Now I want you to widen your legs. And we're gonna work on the diagonal. So what's gonna happen now is your chin that's lifting center is going to just pivot turn slightly so the chin lines up with the knee. You know, the biggest mistake people make when they work their obliques is they actually turn too much. 4 more here. 4, good. 3, last 2. Now we're gonna even turn a little further, about an inch. So now you're just looking slightly past that knee. Same side. 4 more here. Give me 4. We're almost done, guys. 3, 2. Back to the center. Here it comes. For 4 and 3, 2. Now let's look at the other knee. Just look at the other knee. It's a slight turn. Elbows are still staying wide. Looks great, Wendy. Hold and down. Hold and down. Now your eyes are on about a 45 degree angle, just looking about 4 to 6 inches above that knee. 4 more, up, back, 2 more. All right, let's look slightly past that knee. Here we go. It's a little deeper on the oblique. Good. Hold and back. Yes, remember, less momentum makes it more effective. We're working smarter, not harder, yeah. 2 more. And take it back to center. Last 4 and 3. Give me 2 and 1. All right, stretch those legs. Stretch those arms, long body stretch. Hold for four and three, two and one. Now we're gonna roll over onto the abdominals and stretch out those abs. Up on your elbows and push away from your chest. Now if that's not a deep enough stretch for you, go up on your hands and gently push away. You should feel an awesome stretch through the abdominal area. In four and three, now let's take the knees in, round the back, push the buttocks back. Good, hold for four, push the chest to the floor. Three and two, now round up like a cat stretch, pressing your back towards the ceiling and hold it there. For four, push three, two, and now we're gonna step up with one foot, press the heel into the floor. And this is a gentle stretch, don't overstretch. Just when you feel a slight tension, try to press that heel in. Hold for four, three, two, switch legs, press and hold. Again, it's a gentle stretch. Your body's nice and warm. You can give yourself a little push here. For four, three. All right, both heels into the ground. Oh, that feels great through the calves, hamstrings. Relax your head. Stretch through the back of the legs. Now bend your knees and walk your feet in. And I just want you to hang over a straight leg. Ragdoll fashion. Relax that upper body. Relax your head. Just hang. Feeling a gentle stretch to the back of the leg. And I want you to bend your knees, hands on your thighs, and roll up with a round back, keeping your head low, head comes up last. All right, now step out and inhale up. And exhale out. That was some great weight training we did today. We targeted a lot of different muscle groups. Let's pull it over to one side, stretch it over, reach and hold, four, three, now pivot turn, reach both arms forward, press the back heel into the floor, reach your shoulders front, but keeping that body tall, good. Inhale up, pivot turn all the way around, hands go back, stretching out through the chest, press it out. So if you need more challenge, add more weight, but remember, technique before weight. I had to see perfect form. Inhale up. Let the other arm follow, face front, and pull it over. Nice, stretch it out for four, three, two, inhale up. Exhale out, push the shoulders down, and roll it back. For four, push the shoulders down as you roll, three, last two, one more time, inhale up. And exhale out. All right, you guys, you did awesome. I'll see you in a day or two. Good work. Thanks, Wen.
That was great.
Hi, I'm Rosalie Brown. Welcome to the world of personal trainer fitness. At PT Fitness, we have a whole menu of fitness programs. As a matter of fact, studies show that the more you cross-train or vary your exercise programs, the faster and better results you'll receive. You're going to be working smarter, not harder. PT Fitness offers programs for weight training, such as our 30-pound body shaping program, our body gym, multi-bench, and PT exercise ball, to name a few. In our aerobic section, we offer PT cycle, step, trampoline, and jump rope programs. We also have a full selection of fitness accessories, such as weights, gloves, chinning bars, hand grips, ab wheels, and more. The main focus of our program is to get you results fast. Many of our programs are timed and teach you how to work smarter, not harder. As a fitness professional for over 20 years, teaching well over 6,000 classes, I've worked with children, seniors, professional athletes, and celebrities. I know what works. At PT Fitness, we've designed the program that's going to work for you, whether you're a beginner or whether you're an expert. Here's to your health and fitness. Welcome to the PT